have a ball when you're with what is the show for you. Tune in to learn from Miss Rainu.
पंजाब सिंह गुजरात मराठा प्यावन उत्कल बंगा विद्या हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्छल जलधि तिरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे काए तव शय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे.
Welcome to Win with Words, a talk show by kids and for kids, brought to you by Genius Kids in collaboration with TV Asia. Our goal is to develop confidence, public speaking, and communication skills in South Asian children around the world, creating future leaders. We have such an exciting show for you today, celebrating independence and freedom. The focus of today's show is to feature and highlight India using our public speaking and communication skills.
With its mind-bending diversity, from snow-capped mountains to sun-washed beaches, from crusty old bazaars to chichi designer boutiques, from tranquil temples to feisty festivals, from ramshackle rural villages to the magnificent Taj Mahal, India bristles with eclectic mixtures of ethnic groups. Today we celebrate its freedom, India's Independence Day. India's Independence Day was celebrated August 15th every year. India became an independent nation on August 15th, 1947. Hence, this is the 66th celebration.
We have been covering events and talking to different people about their views. Let's begin the show by listening to various tributes by my colleagues about India. Enjoy the show!
India is the motherland of our race, and Sanskrit, the mother of Europe's languages. She is the mother of our philosophy, mother through the Arabs of much of our mathematics, mother through the Buddha of the ideals of Christianity, mother through the village community of self-government and democracy. She is, in many ways, the mother of us all.
India is the cradle of the human race, the birthplace of human speech, the mother of history, the grandmother of legend, and the great-grandmother of tradition. Our most valuable and most instructive materials in the history of man are treasured up in India only, by Mark Twain, who was an American author.
We owe a lot to Indians who thought this had to count, without which no worthwhile scientific discovery could have been made by Albert Einstein, American scientist.
India is a country of diversity, without an element of doubt about it. There has been a lot of talk and discussion about the multicultural, multi-ethnic, and multi-language issues and the very famous unity in diversity. India is also famous for the many personalities that left an indelible mark on the world book.
Among all countries of the world, our country is the best. You may make mistakes though, our country is the best. We have the most, it's so graceful our rivers, to our beautiful, our songs, flower fest. Our country is the best. A righteous birds and animals dwell here at rest. Various crops you can test. Our country is the best. We have everything, sir, the best. Our country is the best. We are thankful to the providence that they let us bud here and rest. We can always proudly announce that our country is the best.
Dance in India has an unbroken tradition of over 2,000 years. Its themes are derived by mythology, legends, and classical literature, two main divisions being classical and folk. Classical dance forms need ancient dance discipline and have rigid rules of presentation. Important among them are Bharatanatyam, Kathakali, Kathak, Manipuri, Kuchipudi, and Odissi.
India is the supreme commander of the Indian defense system. The whole administrative control of the armed forces lie in the Ministry of Defense. The defense minister, Raksha Mantri, is responsible to Parliament all matters concerning defense for the country. The Indian defense system has been divided into three services: the Army, the Air Force, and the Navy.
Britishers came to India as traders, but then they started gaining land and getting control of our entire nation. No one knew who to believe. At the time, everybody thought that we couldn't win the war, but Mahatma Gandhi changed that. He fought for something that he believed in, something that no one had ever done before. When the Britishers started taxing salt, Gandhiji marched 240 miles by foot to the shores to find and make his own salt. The Britishers couldn't stop him. They tried to kill every man, but no one even dared to lift a finger in self-defense. Gandhiji was very strong, noble, and brave. He fought for our country and won it back. We should be proud of Gandhiji and our nation. He gave us loyalty. He gave us our freedom. Thank you.
Mahatma Gandhi, who gave the people of India the weapon of non-violence, which even after decades of his death has upheld its relevance. Rabindranath Tagore, the great poet, has contributed a lot to Indian literature, while artists like Satyajit Ray, Amitabh Bachchan, Pandit Ravi Shankar, and Lata Mangeshkar have shaped up the music and entertainment world. But then there are the industrialists, who just cannot be left out. While talking about great Indian personalities, here we have Dhirubhai Ambani, Ratan Tata, and Azim Premji.
All right, so welcome to Win With Words. As you know, this show is all about building confidence, about public speaking, and developing the future leaders. And I'm here, sitting here with some of my future leaders. So we've been celebrating and talking about independence and freedom in India. So let's talk about your independence and your freedom. Let's begin with that first. What do you think? Is everybody willing to open their hearts and share their views? So I'll begin with the one nodding their head over here.
I think, for me, a lot of people say that America is a land of opportunity, but personally, I believe that wherever you are, you create your own opportunity, and whatever you do creates your future. So even though people move here and think that by moving here, it's easier to get a job, it's easier to become successful, I believe that what you do, what you believe, and what you think, what you say, and what you do, everything is what makes you successful in life.
Excellent answer. Strongly believe in that. Which brings me to you, Mr. Naren. So you've been practicing for the show, and you've been on the show a couple of times. And how do you feel about being on television? You know, a lot of kids are very camera shy. Actually, adults are very camera shy. How do you feel this show is going to help you in the future?
I actually have been on stage before and acted in front of a bunch of people. And this will help me in the future. So when I'm standing in front of that camera, I'm actually not as nervous. And I'm actually more used to being on television. And I can step up to more advanced things.
Wonderful. So on that note, before we wrap up our show today, I want to encourage all of you to not only tune in to Win With Words, but also encourage all your children to participate in our upcoming competitions. We'll be taking this show around 5 different cities in the US between January to May. So be sure to tune in every week on TV Asia to watch Win With Words. And before we wrap up, one quick question for every single one of my guests here. What's one favorite thing about India that you love?
I love the food because my dad owns a restaurant and I love his food.
Well, I like the way they dress because I am like these clothes. I love wearing them. Sometimes I just wear them at home and have fun with my sister and brother because I think that I look really nice in them and it's a way to have fun.
Excellent.
It's time to chill. It's time to watch and learn the drill. Eye contact with posture and ease. Public speaking is such a breeze. All you need is confidence and style. Practice and talk with a big smile. Win With Words is the show for you. Tune in to learn from Miss Rainu. Kids have fun, they feel special and tall. Leaders in the making, let's have a ball. Win With Words.
Thank you for tuning in to Win With Words, a show for kids and by kids. This is Miss Rainu signing off. Until next week, keep smiling.